Hey, what's going on, guys? Vince Del Monte here, online fitness business coach, and I'm about to go give a talk here at Digital Sumo Live on three conversion factors that are often ignored to improve the profits of your marketing. So as you know, we're moving in a new direction with this channel, and I want you guys to go from fit to rich, all right? You guys, I've got the physiques, all right? You've already got the strength, you already got the nice proportions. Now it's time to start monetizing them. One of the big things I teach my coaching students right out of the gate, and this is a number one thing my guy taught me way back in 2006 when I first got started. And that question that he asked me was, hey Vinny, what are your beliefs when it comes to building muscle? What do you stand for? And I found it a really profound question because no one had ever really asked me that. And at the crux of marketing, marketing is just conveying what you stand for, what you believe in. If you ask me, Vinny, what's your definition of marketing? I would say it's believing in one thing. What is at the core of your message? And it's got to be magnetic. At the same time, while it's magnetic for some, it's going to be polarizing for others. All right, and if you look at some of the biggest brands on YouTube, they have all nailed this. All right, they're all crystal clear for what they stand for. We can do some examples here. Jeff Cavalier, what does he stand for? Putting the science back into strength. If you want to look like an athlete, you got to train like an athlete. It's a very simple message he hasn't deviated from in 10 plus years on YouTube. If we look at Elliot Hulse, same story. He's crystal clear on how to achieve your dream body. You got to get strong. If we look at Greg O'Gallagher, same story, but he's the intermittent faster, right? People think Greg invented intermittent fasting because he lives it out. He lives it out better than anybody else, and he's got the results to prove it. And his belief is that you should fast during the day, have a big meal at night, and then lift heavy three times a week with full body workouts. He's got a very simple and clear message. His beliefs are very clear. Nobody's confused about what he's selling, and that's how you need to be. Let's look at a few more examples. Brandon Carter, he's the keto guy. Like, there's no carbs. You're eating fats for fuel, right? So I wanna ask you, what do you stand for? I built an online fitness business around three main beliefs. Skinny guys can achieve their first mega muscle building transformation without drugs, without bogus supplements, in less time. That's what I taught for years. I still teach that. It's like my, those are my beliefs when it comes to building muscle, all right? So you need to get clear today. Before I start teaching you about funnels and tripwires and lead magnets and upsell funnels and affiliate marketing and all that cool stuff, none of that stuff will work if you're not clear on what you stand for. Your beliefs have to be as clear as a vegan's, all right? There's no way you're putting a piece of meat in their mouth, all right? Your message has to be polarizing, not in an intentional way, but in a way that attracts the right people and repels the people that you just don't want to help or are able to help. Until you do that, nothing you do is gonna work. All right, you'll see some pennies roll in, but you're not gonna get the dollar bill. So what I wanna know from you is, what do you stand for? If I go to your Instagram profile, I should not see online coach. Online coach for you, for who? You know, how do you help people? How are you different? What are those points of differentiation? All right? And you've gotta be confident. You've gotta be strong in your beliefs. You know, over the last couple of years, we've been teaching guys how to build muscle with baby weights. You think I attracted some haters with that message? Yes, but guess who we did attract? The right people. Guys who are in their 30s, who understand that it's not what you do in the gym, but it's how you do it, and they're tired of beating up their joints. And now they're after longevity. They have families. They're not competing anymore. And that message resonates with them. All right, so you can't be afraid to state what you stand for. And this is the opportunity for you as an entrepreneur to get crystal clear, because there's way too many wishy-washy people out there that are afraid to upset people. I'm not trying to change anybody's mind on lifting with baby weights. I'm just attracting the people that already have that belief. All right, so that's the key. You're not trying to twist somebody's arm into believing what you believe. You're simply trying to find the people out there that already stand for what you stand for, and then just service them better than anybody else. And that's how you'll build a successful and profitable brand. You'll notice these big guys, like You know, Elliot Hulse doesn't slam people. Greg O'Gallagher doesn't slam people. Jeff Cavalier doesn't slam other people. You don't need to put another belief down to make your belief right. You just have to live your belief out more authentically than anybody else. And then they will say, wow, this is my guy. Not only does he preach it, but he lives it out and he has the results to show for it. And that's how you'll attract the right people. And that's how you'll have maximum impact, maximum influence. And guess what comes with those two things? The income will follow. But you focus on what you stand for before anything else. And if you're not clear on that, ask yourself today, yeah, what do I stand for? You know, what's my mission statement? What do we stand for and what do we stand against? And once you get some clarity on that, then we can move forward. I'd love to hear your feedback in the comment section below. What do you stand for? I look forward to continuing on this journey with you. And if you found this video helpful, let me know in the comment section below. We'll see you next time.